Hello and welcome to Blackfire Gaming for my first review on the Polehammer. Now, first thing to say about this is that it's 27 points, which is a lot. You won't have a lot of room for extra perks or side weapons. It's pretty much going to be picking the armour that you want and maybe a perk. For example, I've gone for fireproof. You can go for friendly, but I'm choosing fireproof. The armour I've gone for to accompany this is a 9-point helmet, because everyone goes for the head, so gotta protect it. I've gone for the 6-point torso and the 3-point legs. A lot of people won't protect the legs to save points, but personally I always go for the legs. As soon as you see some of that leg protection, that's the first thing I go for, so I try and protect them a bit. Right, let's get into the Polehammer stats, shall we? Right, here it is. This great big bastard is very good. It has got lethality written through it like a stick of Brighton rock. It really is brutal. So if we have a look at the advanced stats, you're going to see with the blunt side, for strike damage, it will two-shot everything no matter where you hit, which in its own is pretty good. But using the alt mode, you're going to see that it will one shot heads all the way up to medium armour, which is interesting, because if you pick your battles and you pick your enemies carefully and you get good at, say, feinting and things like that, you're going to end up getting a lot of kills by getting the headshots. So a couple of things that is worth mentioning though: the wind up and release are one of the slowest in the game, so it will take a bit of getting used to, but when you are used to it, it is just absolutely lethal. I mean, this thing is geared to, in my opinion, it's geared towards lighter armoured opponents, but you make contact with these lighter armoured opponents and you're just going to crush them. The thrust is okay. Again, it's more towards lighter armour, but yeah, it's okay. It's not its strongest point, but definitely, you know, if you're going to come up against thicker armor, use the blunt side, you're going to two-shot everything. Lighter armor, switch to the alt mode, and you're going to deal some serious damage. One thing to say about this though is that it won't cleave through people like a sword will. That says that here. Although, that being said, I know me and a few other people have had double kills with this, so, you know, don't know what that's about, but okay. But yeah, it won't cleave through people, and it's saying it won't combo either. So it will take some getting used to, but trust me, it is a very good weapon. Very good weapon to have. So we have a quick look at the different heads you can put on this thing. I haven't unlocked any yet. This is literally how you get it in the game. So I won't go through in much detail. I'll just have a quick scan for you, so you can see what kind of heads you can get. Pretty brutal ones, to be honest. As you can expect, this is fairly good at taking out cav and also using from horseback, because there's a great big spike on top. That works well. But really, it's going to be a case of you trying out yourself. I really like it. It's one I'm playing with a lot at the minute. I usually play with either longsword or arming swords, or sometimes arming sword and shield. But at the minute, I'm enjoying this a lot. I'm finding that once you get the handling of it, it's just so unforgiving to enemies. You know, as soon as they fall for a feint, that's just it. It's just going to be a bloodbath. I've got a couple of clips which I'm going to play for you now. And the first one up is against an Evening Star and also an Execution Sword. And I was quite lucky when I captured this clip, really, because those are kind of weapons which are going to be similar in wind up and, you know, release, things like that. So take a look at the clips, they're not entirely random. There's, like I say, you've got the first one, which is the Evening Star and the Executioner Sword. I've also got ones showing how it can be effective against Cav. Also, some of the clips show how agile it is when you're fighting against more than one person. So it's not just a big slow lumbering, you can move it and be effective against other players, and also getting round the shield wall, especially of the round shield, because that in the game, that'll be for another video, but that thing covers a big area, and this thing, you know, at the right angles, will be able to get round it. So have a look at the clips at the end of the video, and so you got a better idea what it's going to be like against things like the Evening Star and the Maul. There's also one, a short one of the Maul. So yeah, have a look at that, and then judge for yourselves, and let me know in the comments what you guys think of it. But yeah, I'm a big fan. Okay, thank you very much for watching, and if you enjoyed, please subscribe.
For the King!